I am very lucky. It was a divine coincidence or blessings, I don't know. I was in the museum when Ravi Verma's book by Rukmini Verma, his great-granddaughter, was launched. Two things really happened. One, from his records and notes, she has delved into his style of painting. That was amazing. He was always thinking in colors, visualizing everything in colors. He never saw anything in black and white or anything but colors. And the second thing that happened was meeting up with Gitanjali, instant rapport and acceptance. Happy to be here, doing what I'm doing, being appreciated, accepted as one of her team. To begin with, I'm a more a traditional artist, but not a copyist. The first one, yes, everybody has to learn the techniques, so focus on copy. Then they have to create on their own.
Plus my mom, she can't do anything in half measure. It's 100%, and if it's not enough, she will do it again. And that's basically it. So she's got several varieties of her work on display. Some of it is new, some of it is old. Sorry, even if I'm her son, all of it is fantastic. So here's an example of what's so different of the way my mom paints. There's a time when you paint the eyes on the deity, and by tradition, that's when the deity becomes divine. Until then, it's an image. And she talks about how she had to do this for a very large painting of Sharada. It's not on display here. And when she was doing that, she had to wait for the right moment when she felt the confidence that she was empowered to open the eyes of Sharada. This happened at 2 in the morning or 3 in the morning in a totally quiet home in the middle of nobody with her.
I believe in creative freedom. I would like to just fly like Jonathan Segal, and I would want my students and other artists also to